with the simulation experiment based using the for Verilog programming. So two things are to keep in mind, that one is library palette, another is the project. Project palette is basically used to edit your code and compile code. Library code basically used for the simulation. And transcript window to check the any errors are occurred during compilation. Okay. Now go to the file and start with first experiment, that is HS21 marks. New and create project. Then you can give the project convenient project name according to your convenience. I'll give the name as marks 8. Then I'll save it at my convenient location. Then click OK. It asking for overwriting the project, so you can continue if already exist. If not exist, you can continue it. Now I have to edit the, I have to add the code to add your Verilog code. Click on create new file. Then give the name to your file. So I'll give the name as marks821, and choose the add file type as Verilog.
Verilog.
Then click OK. So it will create in project palette, it will create 8MUX821.v file. Then after that, creating this, close this window. Again, come back to your project palette and right click on that file and click edit. So it will appear the edit window. Then insert your code part. So right now I'll do copy and paste. So when you insert your code part, so it will appear red color and blue color and sky blue color, some name get appeared, and even black colors also all get appeared. So blue colors are red color, all are reserved keywords of Verilog program. Then only blue color, these are like special character or symbol, that is equal to at the rate symbol. Then light blue color is the module name. So I have given the module name as 8S21. It's not a file name. It's a module name. You can change to module name, any name also. Okay. Then these violet colors are variables. And this is variable A, B, C. Example A, B, C, input variable, input D variable. Then 8S21, that's square bracket 7 to 0. So you have to, instead of writing 8 variables, you can write with the bus representation. Okay. Now after typing this, so you must keep in mind that you should not use a semicolon at already, always, end case, end mode. You should not use semicolon. So if I, by mistake, if you type semicolon, so I'll type here, then save it. So now we need to compilation. During compilation, show the error message. To compile this, again come back to the project, right click on your Verilog file, then click on compile, selected. So it shows the, at the transcript window, it shows the message that 8S21 failed with one error. So double click on it, it will display the message why the error is occurred. What the reason for that? It says that near equal syntax unexpected equal. So the unexpected equal is nothing but these are the line number 10 to 17 equal. It's unexpected because it's not related to any other neither input nor output. That's why it's saying that unexpected. So that is because of this semicolon. It appear at the always. So remove that one. Again save this one, again recompile it, go to again right click in project and select compile selected. Now it will appear in green color, it will appear the compilation of MUX821.v was successful. Okay. Now after compilation, now next one again, we need to simulate nothing but we need to check the result with the help of waveform. For simulation, you have to go to library and search for the library name, which is work, which they initially task for the library name, which is name is work. So search that work, now nice appear at the top, click on this plus, it will expand the work and it will shows the module name.
Yes,
MUX 821, you can observe in your in code part, it's a module name. MUX 821, the same name will appear here.
Yes,
okay, to simulate, right click on this module name and click on simulate. So it will appear the three windows.
Yes,
one is object window.
Yes,
second one is the leftmost one is the simulation window. This is simulation window, this is object window,
yes,
and one more wave window is here at the bottom.
Yes,
this is wave window. Okay, so we are not working with process window, so no use of it.
Yes,
so in the how to, because wave window is completely now empty.
Yes,
we need to add your input and output variables. To add these in simulation window, the name get appear MUX 821.
Yes,
so right click on it.
Yes,
go to add to wave and click on all item in region. So now you can check in your wave window, all input variables are appeared, that is A, B, C and D and output variable Y. If you click on D plus, so it will show the 8 variables with D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D6 and D3. Now your work is to use the inputs. Inputs is here ABC select line and D0 to D7, 8 output lines. So based on your select line, what will be the output? Need to check it. Okay. To give the input, so right click on variable A and click on force. In force, after selecting force, it will pop up on window with name that force selected signal. You have to change it, check the variable name A, and only have to change the value.
Yes,
and now I'll change this to 0. You can change also to 1 also. No, then click OK. Then right click again on B, again force, again I'll change this to 1, click OK. Similarly C, I'll click type 0. Now select line I have given it, that is 010.
Yes,
now I'll give the input 8 lines, D0 to D7. I'll give the again same thing. I click on D, click on force.
Yes,
now here I have to give an 8 bit binary number, that is 10110101. Okay, 8 inputs are there. Yes, then click OK. After giving the inputs, our next work is to check the, you need to run it. Simulation, you have to run it. To run that one, so go to simulation.
Yes,
and you will appear run.
Yes,
run 100 meaning is 100 nanoseconds. Okay, so you can 100 value, you can change it. Then click on run 100. Now waveform, the check in the waveform window, the green lines are get appeared.
Yes,
so green lines indicate that need to cross check your result. I have given A as 0, B is 1 and C is 0, and input is 10110101. I need to check the output. Now output 1, why is 1? So why the output is 1? Because of A, B, C is 010, so which is in decimal is 2. So check the D2 variable is 1, that's why the output is 1. So this is your execution steps for the mod 8 is to 1. So next we'll move on to the D flip-flop.